Hey, it's me. Jessica, hold on. Come on. T. From the Pattersons, taking a train to Tibet. Hey, look at here. Man, like I said, you got to keep it good grooming up, you know. Well, in these times, even if you're alone, you want to look good to yourself, okay? So just know that. Look good to yourself, because, you know. No, another time for that. Okay, that's that. As you can tell, wait a second, you can't tell. It's my, you know, book culture. This is a time, if any time, for you to be into your books. Now, I'm going to send. Should I say, oh, yeah, I could tell you all now. Is this thing here? It's not here. Is this thing here? Where is it at? Did I put it over there? Anyway, I want to show you all what I'm going to send. But don't matter. Next up. But you know, I was looking, before I get to that, do some little research. This was left here, you know, I guess these people, you know, I'm house sitting. Well, I'm at an undisclosed location. It's just me. They all someplace in the sun, you know, trying to get their vitamin D, you know, out of the state, because New York is on lockdown. So I'm here house sitting. And, you know, I go over across town, do my little walk every day, go across town to complete where I post up at. But here's the thing, you know, here's the thing. New York City, they said the buses are free. You can get on the buses for free, the back door open like that. But then they have the special buses that are not supposed to be free where you can pay for the thing. I'm in a conundrum. I'll tell you that. Another time I'll go to something. But so I'm looking at this. This is some kombucha. Seriously, organic kombucha. Oh, I guess it's kombucha. They say kombucha. I say kombucha. Let's look it up. What the heck is this stuff here? Because, you know, I might, you know, this has been sitting out here. I don't think it has to be refrigerated. How do you spell this thing? K-O-M-B-U-B. Oh, there it is, right there. Kombucha benefits. Let's see what. Wait, come on. Benefits. Let's look up the benefits. Okay. What does it say? Let me see. Kombucha is a potential source of probiotics. That's that stuff for your gut. You know what I mean? But I think it's overrated. I'm not going to get into it right now. May provide benefits. The benefits of green tea. Hey, I got green tea. Why would I have kombucha when I got green tea? I can just do the green tea. I guess. Okay. What else do they have here? Let me see what else they got here. Contains antioxidants. I guess that's good. Kombucha can kill bacteria. But there's good bacteria, bad bacteria. Does kombucha know which is good and bad? I don't know. May reduce heart disease risk. Okay. May. They're hedging their bets. May help manage type 2 diabetes. Okay. I'm pre-diabetic. May help protect against cancer. Everything protects against cancer, please. Healthy when made properly. Oh, it's got to be made. Okay. Oh, what the hell is this going to have? May help strengthen the immune system. Get into that stuff. The gut healthy benefits of kombucha may also provide an immune system boost. Yeah, okay, that's going to get everybody to be buying it. May aid depression treatment. Well, I'm the kind of guy, the glass is always 3/4 full with me. Talk about glass being full. Drink your water. Okay, see, this is a glass, right? For me, I'm always like this. Everybody else is something half and half. Me, I'm always up, so that doesn't apply to me. Everybody's different, you know what I mean? May boost cardiovascular health. Okay, that's good. Now, let's see what else we got down here. How much kombucha can you drink a day? Lose weight and help with side effects. Oh, we want to know this. Let's go to this one. Side effects. Kombucha is probably safe for most adults when taken by mouth. Kombucha can cause side effects when contaminated, including stomach problems, yeast infections, allergic reaction, yellow skin jaundice, nausea, vomiting, head and neck pain, and death. What? Hey, nah. I don't care. Eight for me. What? Oh, God, side effects. I usually go further. I usually just don't read headlines. You know, I'm the kind of person back in the day, I read all of the Wall Street Journal articles, skipping the page, whatever. No, I'm not doing it. I got to do something. What else got to do? I got mine. Side effects when contaminated. Okay, when contaminated. May include stomach problems, yeast infections, allergic reaction, yellow skin jaundice, nausea, vomiting, head and neck pain, and death. Okay, I can say when contaminated, but this has been sitting out here for I don't know how long, so I don't know, but I ain't messing with it. Let me go to my buffered vitamin C. Let me go to something I know. Oh, man. This is why you should read. Just book, read. This is why you should read. This is my... I just took my pill. I took this pill last night. Because when I was little, my grandmother, you know, we used to take this and change the seasons, take the thing to deworm you, you know, all that stuff. So I got this pill from Watkins Health Food Store last week. And so I just took it because I figured this is my day of fasting. Mondays I fast. So what I would do is, you know, since I'm fasting, I took the pill last night. You know, this is a Monday. What am I going to do here? This is prune juice. I used to do prune juice. I shouldn't say this, but I did a bowel movement. And when I was a kid, I looked and I didn't see no worms or nothing like that. So I don't know. Maybe they kill them and anything. But I got to get a glass. Here we go. Let me get this. What is this? Cute. Hey, New York City. This Empire State Building. It's where I live. I mean, where I live in South Africa. But they ain't letting nobody in the country. In fact, Rwanda just closed its borders. Yeah, Mugabe, the commie guy, you know, Bill Clinton's boy. He just closed the borders for Rwanda. His first African country closed the borders. But I can't get back into South Africa until the ban is lifted. I don't know. So here's my vitamin C. I take my vitamin C and bump it. But, you know, I just realized, because, you know, vitamin C, it goes through me, but sometimes it makes I don't know, it does something strange to my system. So I have to be careful with this vitamin C business. I like that. So what I was going to say, so I use, I'll use prune juice to clean me up. I mean, you know, all the people, there's all kinds of teas, you know, smooth move or whatever have you. And prune juice is my go-to thing. I found a long time ago it's the best thing for my system. It's gentle, you know, whatever have you, helps me. But again, I'm fasting, but I'm not. I eat right, you know, so it doesn't matter. But now I got to make sure this vitamin C. Anyway, so I'm going to take that. But what was I talking about? Oh, books. So what I'm doing is I'm sending my grandnephew, because I can't go down there, you know what I mean? Sending him this present here, this book. I told you before, this book, this is, they don't read, they don't watch my commentaries like most people, don't worry about it, so they're not going to know ahead of time, but that's me. That's right. I was a model back in the 80s. And so this is interesting because he'll get this and he'll have this, he won't be a reader, but he's only going to be 1 year old next week on the 5th of April, 2 weeks, I guess. But anyway, so it could be like, that's me, his grandfather, talking to him when he gets this age. But when he gets, this is going to be a big kid, though, you know, and guess what? I'm the model, so I'm all the way through the book, you know, every time you see the old man, that's me. Hey, so you get this book and you'll have me. Okay, no. But what I'm going to send with him also is this fine T-shirt, right? So I got, that's the book I got, I got it from Book Culture. And so I'll send a book. So you said, well, you send this big kid's only 1 year old. First of all, this kid is, he was preemie, but this kid is grown big. His father's big. He used to be a football player, you know, college and went to the pros for a second, you know. So he used to be a football player. And this boy big now. He got a big head. I don't call him big head, nothing like that, because you know, you don't want to damage the kid, whatever have you. But he got a big head. That boy going to be big. So when he gets to be this size here, he's probably be like, maybe like 10 years old. So hopefully, when I finally get down there, we'll put the maybe I'll encase this T-shirt, you know, so we'll have it in his room, right? So he'll grow up with it. So when he can choose his own books, you know, I guess he chose it earlier, he'll probably be big enough when he chooses his own books, you know, to wear this T-shirt. So it'll always be, you understand what I'm saying? So it's, I think like this. I'm not bringing things like that. Okay, so that's going with him. I'm still, actually, I didn't, this is for the book club, you know what I mean? For Eidos Book Club. So I'm still reading. This I got from Percy Lee Anderson. His self-published book, he got him off the street. He's going to update this stuff, you know. Anyway, it's a book from him. He got another book too, but he told me he's going to make, anyway, it's going to update. So I'm going to get that from him. But I listened to 5150, you know, Corey Holcomb up there in California, and they come on every Tuesday night, I guess it is. But sometimes he has on his panel, he has on, you know, it's Darlene, the OG Ortiz, is there. Sometimes they have Craig Fast comes through, some other people come through. But also what happens is, what's the name comes through? Zoe Williams from Dash Radio. And so he's, Joe Williams is into Krishnamurti, this guy here, you know, this guy here. So, you know, I've never read him. I've read other Indian guys, you know, other Indian gurus and stuff like that, and whatever. But this guy sounds really interesting. I saw some of his YouTube things, so I got his two books, so I'm going to read that. I might send one to my sister. Yeah, change her mind. Not change her mind, but, you know, people get inspired by certain things, you know. Interesting, both my sisters, well, when I go down there, I go to church with her anyway, but she's going to the sad one now. They got virtual church now. church is in trouble, you know, as far as finance goes. And they're supposed to be helping people, so I don't know. Prune juice. Run through my system. So what I'll do is I'll send all that down, the mail, hope the mail gets through. And but back to these churches and things that's happening. It's interesting, both my sisters got more into church again, and my wife, I pray every morning, right? So my wife, she prayed, and then she started, I have a certain prayer room when we're home, right? So she started to take out her little Bible, because she's, what are they, Anglican? Whatever it is. Sometimes I would go to church just to support her. I'm not a Christian, you know what I mean? I don't believe in heaven. I don't believe in hell. I don't believe in a devil. I don't believe in immaculate conception. I don't believe in purgatory. None of that stuff, right? So you can leave that alone, right? But I go to church for the community thing and just to support her, but there ain't going to be no community church. But she just told me, I just talked to her, that down in South Africa now, oh, yeah, they still Saturday, they put on their white, they still go to church, whatever, having to be holding hands. Man, when they finally realize that stuff hit, but at least there's no more load shedding and no the water's still being on. They need to cut their race, so they have the highest data rates possible on the planet. So they need to deal with that. Hopefully the kids and the people will deal with that. A lot of stuff is going to happen because people are getting that little small thing and they start to think, hey, why is this happening? Why is this? Why do they keep on bailing out these big companies and they don't bail out the little guy? All those kind of things. Here's the thing. What they do is they rule from above. They got that whole royalist, you know what I mean? The king knows everything like that. And so now the senator knows everything. The president knows. No. This has got to be, we'll tell you what to do and we'll give you this. No, what's going to happen right now with people is, since they're talking to each other and was sequestered in little groups, people are basically going to say, wait a second, we have an input into this too. This is not what you're going to do. This is how you're going to spend our tax money. No. You're no longer going to, you know, give it to, you know, try to bail out. You're trying to bail out. I hear. It's a rumor. But I'm going to spread this rumor because I want people to address it right now. They're bailing out the fracking industry, which is never, everybody knew from the beginning it was just a money scheme to get you more. Anyway, that ain't going to happen. You're going to say, no, that money you use the frack or the airline industry or the whatever, petroleum, whatever it is, no, this is going directly to the people. No, we're not going to, what's it called, a means test. No, people are suffering. Boom, 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 boom. Go directly to them. I'm sorry, I'm going off. It upsets me when people don't realize you're being hustled. As Malcolm would say, you're being bamboozled. I mean, and I don't think people, in the time of crisis, people can't be bamboozled no more. These politicians are doing their thing. They're all, nah, it ain't going to happen. I'm just letting you know, because I know it ain't going to happen. And you do too. Check you later.